Our final honoree this evening is Mr. Brendon Miller. He played football again in 1988 and 1991. Brendon, if you'd come forward. Brendon. Brendon was also a two-sport athlete, playing baseball in 1989 and 1990, but is recognized this evening for his contributions to the football program. Most fondly, Brendon remembers kicking game-winning field goals in back-to-back weeks to defeat Lambeth and Evansville in the 1991 season. Brendon was named first-team NAIA All-American in 1991, he was as a punter, and was a national leader in punting average in the NAIA Division II in 1991. He was named first team Mid-South Conference in all NAIA District 32, both 90 and 91, and Mid-South Academic All-Conference an NAIA District Scholar Athlete in NAIA 1989, 1990, and 1991. Brendon was named First Team All-Mid-South Football Conference, All-NAIA District 32 in 91, both as a punter and kicker, being All-Conference and All-District on both offense and defense. He was voted as a Special Teams Player of the Year in both 1990 and 91 for the Union College football team. Brendon still owns the record. Listen to this. Brendon still owns a record for the longest punt at Union with a 73-yard boot against Georgetown.
Yes!
October 1991. It rolls down. I give you Brendon as our third inductee tonight in the Union Athletic Hall of Fame. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, and I got to say it's a pleasure to be back here at Union College. It's been a long time for me, and I'm very thankful. I'm trying to get this fixed here. To be back in Marble. Tell that I went to school here. It's Barbara, not Barbaraville. And I'm very appreciative for my time here at Union College. Now, when Ivana told me that I could make some remarks, she said I had 3 to 5 minutes. Well, she doesn't know a mountain lawyer that practices law and is in full campaign mode right now how long I would speak when I got up here. So bear with me. I have some people to thank and some things to cover and a couple of points that I want to make, as always. If you catch up with me, I don't think I gave him any background. Of course, I practiced law for the last 20 years here in Eastern Kentucky and been the elected county attorney of Breathitt County for 3 terms. So I've been away from sports for a little while and in the courtroom most of the time. But my time here at Union College was so special to me, and it trained me. I came here in 1988 as a young guy that was overweight, didn't have a whole lot of I didn't know what I was going to do. I thought I'd come down and play some football for a little while, so I gave it a try. I came down to Union, Georgetown, and Cumberland. And thank God I chose you. We'll say that here. But I came here in 1988 as a guy that was just going to give it a try. And I ended up in 1992 as all the things that you heard there as a national leader, first team All-American. And that was all because of the things that I learned here Union College. When I came here a boy and I left a man. I'm so thankful for this institution and the things that it has done for me that has spurred me on in my legal career, my political career, my business career, and now my media career. And I'll fill you in on that, folks, for you guys that don't know. Heck, all these guys from 1991, this team of distinction, I played with these guys for 2 years. And the reason that they probably are the team of distinction, they got me to retire that last year, so they can actually be good instead of field time in the bullpen out there with Dave Duncan and those guys. Guys, I have a lot of people to thank for where I am today. First of all, I'm going to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and God the Father. We all have God-given talents that we can develop. The Lord has given it to us all. It's what we do with it. You hear a lot of athletes and people say, well, athletes shouldn't give glory to God. Well, yes, we should, because we have the talents that were given to us, and what we do with it is up to us. And thank God I was able to develop my talent a little bit and do something in my career. But basically, there's a couple of people that have really, really, really affected my life as well. And first people that I want to talk about, my mom and dad. Now, I may get choked up, but they're sitting here right now. I'm still fortunate enough to have I'm 47 years old, to have my mother and father still with me. Now, mom had a little incident there a couple weeks ago. She's on a walker right now where she fell and broke her hip. But these are the two most important people in my life. They gave me every benefit when I was growing up. And these are the only two people that I can tell you. We played all over the southern United States. Hattie knows it. Darren knows it. We drove. My mom and dad were in every game. Okay? You know, I don't know. Sometimes my two boys are playing now. Sometimes it's hard to get to their games. Mom and dad drove to every game to watch their son kick 4 or 5 footballs. Now, that is awesome to me. And I always had the support to succeed in everything that I did because of these two people. Mom and Dad, I love you so much. Thank you. This is my mom. Everybody wants to know where my toughness came from. I practice a lot. Mom fell and broke her hip 3 weeks ago today. Okay? I walked in. I was in court in another county. Came in. First words to me was, when's your thing down at Union? She's laying there with the nurse, and that's the first thing that she asked me. Mom, Dad, love you. Thank you so much. I have another gentleman here with me here tonight, my high school football coach, Mike Hogan. Those of you from Brendon, I came in here in 1988 from Brendon County High School. Like I said, a kid that was not bodily prepared to play college football or baseball for that fact. You know, I had a lot of talent that I should have developed a lot more in high school, but Coach Hogan knew we needed somebody. The special teams was very important. And Coach will tell you to this day, he doesn't know a thing about it. Didn't know a thing about kicking a football, punting a football, anything like that. But he gave me the opportunity to develop my skill and be a contributor to the football team when I should have been out catching passes and playing defensively and things along those lines. All I wanted to do was kick a football. And Coach allowed me to do that. And Coach Holcomb, 3-time state champion, I got to be coach with him for 2 of those. Coach, thank you so very much. Your influence on my life and what happened here at Union College is a direct result of what the basis that you gave. Thank you, sir. That is the real guy that gave me confidence, and I have not seen Coach Matt Ballard in probably a decade. He was our head football coach here at Union College. Kind of a funny story. It came down to me for Georgetown, Cumberland, and Union. Okay, so I went on recruiting visits and probably not ended up at Georgetown, but we won't say that. There hadn't been a guy named T.G. Shug there that you guys saw on the weather at WKYT quite a bit. T.G. had been a sophomore all-conference kicker, and I said, well, I came down here to Union, and there was a guy named John Ross here. And Coach Ross was kind of like a used car salesman, I believe. He told me, you know, you come to Union, we'll do this for you, we'll do that for you. We need you to come kick football for us. So I signed on the line and came on down. And lo and behold, when I came, Coach Matt Ballard was here. So things have changed up a little bit, but Coach gave me an opportunity. Okay, like I say, I came in, I wasn't ready. You had to run a mile and a half as a condition test when you came in. I'd been at the Cotton Mac State Baseball Tournament the 2 weeks before, completely out of shape. I didn't finish the mile and a half in 12 minutes. Just couldn't do it. I was in such terrible condition. But by the time I left, I ran that thing in under 11 minutes. You know, because that's what it took to get the job done. But Coach Ballard always had so much confidence in me that he gave me opportunities that I probably shouldn't have received. You know, here at Union, I didn't have a position coach. No, I was just kind of a freelancer on my own, I would come out every day, stretch, do agilities, and I was on my own. You know, the other team was where the baseball field is now. That was our practice field. And I came over to Birdstown Field and kicked by myself. You know, I didn't have to do it if I didn't want to. But Coach Ballard had confidence. He told me, Coach Ballard, Coach Gill, Coach Bryce Askren early on in my career, all told me, he said, Brendon, we got confidence. And he said it to my, you know, he told me, he said, we got confidence, you'll go do your job, go do it. And he gave me the opportunity for 4 years. I took every punch snap. My sophomore through my senior year, kicked every ball that was kicked here except for kickoffs. I wasn't very good at that, but extra points and field goals. And those guys made such a difference in my life. You know, the thing that I like to talk about when I've given commencement speeches, I've done this, I've done that, but I like to talk about a thing called character. And this is something for you seniors, you know, that you need to remember, is the character that you exhibit and that you've learned from being an athlete will actually spur you in life to do many things that you don't think that you can do. I mean, I was a little old kid from Jackson, Kentucky. Never thought about going to law school. All of a sudden, I ended up in law school. I ended up a three-term county attorney, this, that, practiced law for 20-some-odd years now, and would have never thought of it. The Lord works in mysterious ways and puts you in positions that you never think about. But having character is the key. And how do you define character? How I define it is what you do when nobody's looking. It's pretty simple. Is whenever you look around, it's like me out there on that football field. Nobody saw me. I mean, Sherry Payne might have saw me. You know, she might have seen me over here practicing by myself, doing kicking coffee corners, kicking extra points, doing situational things on my own. But if I didn't put in the work myself, I would have never reached any of the goals, any of the awards that they just read off to, that Coach Lane did. And that's what it takes, folks. Hard work. You know, I tell everybody I'm not the smartest guy in the world, but hard work will put you where you need to be. And I also wanted to, well, I'll read this first. These guys, Hattie, Darren, you'll know what I'm talking about. Coach, our last game, had this letter to the seniors that I keep with me all the time. Okay? Now, Coach started out some things that was not true. This is what he wrote about me. He said, you know, Brendon Miller, the pretty boy from Jackson, who thought he was the heartthrob desire of every UC co-ed. Now, that was not true. Did not need to be written, but I think he needed some comic relief. And he said, I was going to start a business going around the country painting numbers on people's legs. Well, if you know me at that time, I did some pretty crazy stuff. Okay, I had wore a do-rag, had a flat top, long hair in the back. I had kids that came to the game with their hair cut like that, and all sorts of stuff. It's real things that I wouldn't do now, and I don't want people to know, even though this is on video. But my junior year, we ended up, they took, and I have one of my towels with me. Of course, I always wore these big towels that had stuff written on it. UC Foot Power and all this stuff, you know. I always took the adage, if you look good, you play good. So we try to do that stuff. And so I started drawing numbers on my legs, all that sort of stuff. And then crazy, which means nothing, but that's what Coach was talking about. But he goes on to say, and I get a little choked up when I read this, he says, seriously though, Brendon is the perfect example of a true team player in Mr. Clutch. Truly dedicated to excellence, he gets my vote for most likely to succeed. I've kept that forever, through law school, through law practice, through many things that I've done, and that has meant the world to me. And I thank Coach Ballard. You know, I've tried to track it. I haven't seen him in a decade, but I thank that gentleman for everything that he did for me and made this possible. Also want to thank my teammates. Of course, we've got Tony Hatmaker, Darren McWhorter here with us right now. You guys, Tony snapped to me half the time, and I appreciate you guys. We had a good time. And guys, I'll tell you what, you seniors, you never have a better time in life. You know, you always wish every step, everybody wants to graduate to the next step. You know, you wanted to get out of high school, you wanted to go to college. Well, high school was a lot easier. You want to get out of college and go make some money and have a career. Well, I knew about anything to go back to college. Right? You know, same thing with law school. You get out practicing law. Well, it's been nice to be back in law school. But enjoy your time. Enjoy your time. And I also want to thank one gentleman named Tommy Poston. Tom has been an advocate of mine. He's been part of this board, I believe. And also, he does a lot for Union College. And I appreciate him. He nominated me for the Hall of Fame. And I want to thank, he couldn't be here tonight, but I want to thank you, Tommy, for nominating me. Now, I made an illusion, and I love you, Tom. Thank you very much, Dave. Good friend. I made an illusion before. Just to let everyone know, I run a media business now. On top of everything, it's called Bluegrass Sports Station. And the reason I say that is because we have Scott Warren over here today, who shoots for the Mountain Advocate. Scott's going to let us put some of the pictures of tonight on our site. We're also videoing the entire proceedings here tonight. So we'll get that posted hopefully on Facebook and on our website called BluegrassSportsNation.com. So follow that if you can. You can follow me. I run around and act like I'm a photographer and take pictures of the UK and Louisville and the Bengals and Reds and all this sort of stuff now. So I have a good time doing that when I'm on the court. So follow us if you can. I'll put that little plug in there. But I love this place. I really do. The best times of my life were right here when I grew up. And all I can say is it's great to be a Union College Bulldog. Thank you all very much.
Not be here tonight, and we're hoping that he'll be able to be with us next year so we can present him at that particular time. I'd like to thank everyone for allowing me to talk to you tonight. One more time, I'd like for the team of distinction, let's have them all stand, that team, and give them a round of applause. One more time. Into the Hall of Fame, if you would stand, and let's give them more and more. Seniors, I wish you nothing but the best. Thank you for allowing me to be with you.